there's a light. What is going on? You're back here on my channel with Kay. If you guys are new, which I know there's some new subscribers, so thank you guys for subscribing to my channel. I'm glad you guys have been enjoying my videos as I've been having fun like filming it and editing and all that jazz. My name is Kayla. For everyone who is new, I'm glad to be recording and putting something up because I like to do this. And it is still winter break, which I'm glad. I have this week and next week, and then the next week after is when I'm back to school. So I thought, let me just do a chill day at home vlog and take you guys along with one of my days at home. Like, today is Thursday. It is not morning. It's like 1 p.m., but you know, slow start, but it's okay because you know why? It's a break. So yeah, so I thought, let me just take you guys along with my day. I don't really have anything planned. I have a few things like on my list today, but I have nothing really like officially planned. So I thought that it would be cool to just take you guys along. We'll just be hanging out today. You'll be hanging out with Kay. Welcome. Hey. And I have a few surprises, I guess, or updates to show you guys. I guess hint hint is in regards to my room. I mean, I'm sure you guys saw it in the title today, but we're gonna get there. All right, first, I'm like out of breath and I have not eaten anything yet for breakfast, so I'm just gonna have a bowl of cereal. That's most likely what happens. I don't eat until later in the day. Like now it's like what, 1 something? And I'm just eating the first meal today. Let me know if you guys can relate. Now that we're home, like, our eating schedule is just so off. I just had water because I was just jamming out to music. I showered and was just jamming out to some worship music. So, you know, I had some energy just now. Alrighty, so we're gonna head downstairs and get some laundry in because that's what today's gonna be. Alrighty, so my sister is working in the other room, so I can't be too loud. So let me get things situated. Let me prop you guys up. Guys, so I love this cereal. Let me know if you guys are aware of this cereal. Like, so there was no more milk, so I'll just go to the store later or something. But I'm just gonna have the banana pudding. Okay, why is it dark? And I'm also gonna have some strawberries and some blueberries. At least I'm having a healthy breakfast, you know? I'm here eating and I forgot to get the book that I wanted to read. I'm trying to see, should I show you guys my room now or later? I think I'll show you guys now, you know? Why wait? Why wait? So, let's see. We have my room door and then one of my closets here, and I hung up my hat up here because there was like hooks on the door. I'm gonna show you. Yeah, there was like these hooks drilled on the door. So I was like, you know what? Let me just hang this up. It was kind of cute. Then I have one of my drawer sets over here with like some books and journals on here. And then I have all my like hair oils, perfumes, lotions, hand sanitizer over here. So I have my tripod. Then over here I have my bookshelf that used to be like on the other side of my bed. And up here I just keep my headphones, hair ties. Here's all of my books. Yeah, so I kept two of my candles over here. And then over here I have my journals, which I'm gonna be using this journal soon. So I took that out. I just keep my iPad here. Maybe it's not the safest, but I do it. Then I just have other journals, like my Bible study journal, my prayer journal. That's everything, books, sketchbooks. And then like this basket has like quick things like post-it notes, markers, pens, and flashcards in there. So that is like this corner. Then I have a white circle rug next to my bed. I put my bed in the center of the room now. So here's how it's looking like. Please excuse, this blanket is not folded, but I just keep it on my bed so I can like cover with it when it gets cold during the day. And then yeah, that's what it's looking like. So I think it's really cute. What do you guys think? And then up here, I just keep all my baby photos. So I think it's pretty nice. Then next to my bed, I have my nightstand, then a extension cord for like my charger and stuff. And I have a rug on this side as well. This remote I can use to turn my lights on. And it's like really pretty and neat. I like it a lot. It's like a cute little vibe. And at night, it's like so cozy. So yeah, we're just gonna turn those off. My windows. It's like really nice. There's like a nice view overall. And when it snows, it's like so pretty outside too. But also when it's sunny, it's like pretty. And look, I love when it's clear skies and sunny and everything. And over here, I just hold my two like bags over here. I have my lap desk here, my plant that I love, and I have my coconut oils over there too. In this corner, I have my garbage can, my step stool with this throw blanket situation. It's kind of cute. You know, my painting, my mirror, still is over here, and then my bulletin board for my desk area. This is probably where I'm gonna be working next semester. So my desk used to be directly ahead in front of like the window, but now I have more space and it's like so great. I was like, why like cramp my desk in this corner when I could shift it a little bit? So I now have my desk area with like half window, half like bulletin board area and all that good stuff. So here it is. I brought my plant from downstairs up here and cleared some desk space. So now it's like really like minimal and like strictly for working or reading. Soon I'm gonna be doing my Bible study this afternoon. And I'm currently reading into Esther. So it's a really great book and I'm loving it so far. So I have my printer. My closet, you know, still remain the same. I did reorganize it though, or fix things up for the new year. And then yeah, I have my drawer sets with a few of my Bibles here, and then this book about home decorating. Here is the room update. It's so nice. And that is the situation. I also forgot to show you guys the view outside this window, which I love. It's like so nice. And when it snows, it's like beautiful too. So that's why I didn't really want to move this desk area to like say here or like there. And I also love the luxury of being able to walk barefoot. We're this far into the video and I forgot, but it is a brand new year, guys, so happy new year. It is 2021 and I'm feeling okay, and I hope you guys are too, with new start, you know, new beginnings. The first 7 days of my year, because today is January 7th, so the first 7 days of the year for me is definitely going swell. It's going a-okay. I'm definitely feeling blessed in this new year and thankful for so much. And I'm thankful for all that I learned in 2020, all that has happened, and you know, we know that God makes no mistakes. And all things happen for a reason. I'm glad like all that I learned and like been through, and the good and the bad. And while many people can see 2020 being, you know, a bad year, considering the circumstances that you went through, you know, that can look different for everyone, but no matter how much of a bad year that 2020 looked like, there were also some really good highlights in 2020 and some good things. So just, you know, guys, try to keep in mind that like 2020 was still a year of learning for some of us, and a good thing. And I hope in 2021 you guys can look up to a few things and have things to look forward to. And yes, before I head into what I'm gonna do or show you guys right now, one of my desires this year in 2021 is to memorize more scriptures. So I read, you know, quite a few books in 2020, like books of the Bible, that is what I'm talking about. I read 10 books, I tallied off, which was really great for me, because going from reading none, I guess, before the age of 20 to reading 10 in 2020, I wanted to backtrack now, or as I'm reading more books, I want to backtrack to the ones that I read and start to memorize scriptures. Okay, I got distracted, but yes, I want to memorize more scriptures, so this way my toolbox can be filled with the right things, aka my heart will be filled with scripture. I can always think of things from above and always have the scriptures that I am memorizing in mind. And yeah, so that's basically that. So far I can say in the first 6 days of the year I memorized 6 scriptures. And so now let me just show you before I like progress. I was gifted this wonderful prayerful planner, which I absolutely love. If you guys own one of these, let me know, because I love it. Like already, like I love it. The pretty looks of it and the beauty of the journal. It's just so great. So this is a prayerful planner. So it says, where prayers, planning, and purpose come together. So this is really like such a great tool. I really, really just love it. So it comes with stickers, and then it also comes with like a step-by-step how to use the prayerful planner. First, like in the first few pages, you can have like a prayer request, and that's a prayer request page. So far, I just prayed for like my family, like my immediate and extended, and then prayed for like my friends, and then there's also a section for like praise, which I love this because like I never really documented like who I'm praying for. So say in the moment I'm thinking, okay, like I want to pray for all the students in this world, so I can just write that down, and then throughout the day or later in the day or even in that moment, I can immediately like pray about that. Or the same goes for praising. So I just love this. Also, there's a page here where you can like, it's kind of like a checklist where you bubble in each day that you read your word. Obviously, I am behind because I only had like 2 days filled in, but I did read the last like 4 days or like 5 days. I love this because especially in 2020, us Christians have learned that like our time more or less could have been compromised, or we probably didn't spend as much time in our word as we would like to, or maybe skipped a morning, or our, you know, Bible study time was probably jumbled up, our prayer time, you name it, like as we were trying to readjust in our schedule, in our days. So this page, you know, encourages you to check off like every day that you read God's word. And it says whether you do a devotional or you read a short verse, you're able to read an entire chapter that day, still document it down. I like that because I know in 2020, one of my things was, I guess I set the bar really high for myself, because in the first half or first, okay, pre-pandemic, of 2020, I was able to get a chapter in the morning or a chapter in within that day, and also have my other endeavors with school, classes, hangouts. But after the pandemic, like I was getting a little jumbled up with this 2021 prayerful planner and, you know, word checklist. This encourages me and tells me like, all right, Kay, you know, you don't have to finish a whole chapter each day. And if you don't, it does not mean that, you know, you aren't successful in God's eyes. The whole idea is to commune with Him and have that time. And no matter how fast or slow or how short or long it takes you to read a certain book or read a chapter or get through it, it doesn't really matter. What does is that if you're understanding the chapter or the verse, or you apply that verse or word or chapter to your day, and like you meditate on God's word throughout the day. I hope that is making sense, but this just helps us to exercise like being okay with not meeting our goals. Because ultimately, it's the plans that God has for our lives and the purpose that He has for us that prevails. So, if our plan is to finish like 3 chapters in one day and we can't get there, but we read one and like we are blessed by it, and we praise God for that chapter and like what we learned in that, that's what matters more than like reading more content and you're not really understanding the meat and the bones and the fruits that are produced. And what I'm gonna go through right now, which took me so long to get through, but it's okay. What I'm gonna finally get through is my planning for today. And then my favorite part is that there's a verse up on the top right, like for every day, there's a new verse. So this is what has been helping me reach my desired goal of memorizing a verse, more scripture this year. So by me being able to memorize a verse each day has been so helpful. And I'm just so thankful for this. Like, this is like everything that I do and need on one prayerful planner. So I just love it. I just sit here, plan my day, memorize the verse, and right now it's even still a surprise. I'm not looking at it. And yeah, so once I have memorized that day's verse, I go back to the previous days and keep it in my mind. And kind of quiz myself, and then I proceed with my day. But yeah, like, I literally been loving it. So now let me see what today's verse is. Oh, today is Acts 2:28. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence. I love this. So I'm gonna go ahead and plan my day right now. You will fill me with joy in your presence. You will fill me with joy in your presence. You will fill me with joy in your presence. You will fill me with joy in your presence. This whole time my phone has been buzzing and going, and let me check what's going on, because I've been trying to not be on my phone that much. And especially while I'm memorizing scripture or in Bible study time, I try not to do that, because this is a strictly time with me and the Lord. So yeah, that's that. As I told you guys, I'm reading the book of Esther right now. It's the book before Job. And I'm learning so much, and the book is just so amazing. So I have in my Bible study journal, like, notes so far that I went over, some information on, like, the history, and I wrote down, like, just, like, I guess facts about, like, who is who. And also, I like to, like, reference, like, different translations when I read. So my main read is New King James. But I also brought up, which one is this? Oh yeah, my Christian Standard Bible. So I can reference, like, both. And I'm gonna go ahead and, braid up these ends and then re-dip it. Alright, I hope this lighting is not weird. It's like a lot of light here. So I'm just gonna braid it down all the way to the end. And then once we dip it in hot water, it's gonna seal it. Like, but I have to make the water, like, really hot. Like, yesterday when I dipped it, it was not that hot. Like, it was, but surprisingly it did not do what it needed to do, so. I'm missing the oil on my scalp while I'm here, because I've been trying to do it the past few days, but I've been forgetting. So yeah, so I have this Groganics hair growth oil, on the spot growth oil, which is really good, and it keeps my scalp moisturized, because moisture is, like, what I need. My hair will, like, drink it up. And then I also have tea tree oil, so I'm about to just apply these. So let me just heat this water up. Wow, look at all that steam. Can you guys see? I don't know. But it looks so crazy. Alright, so the pasta is warmed up. Now we're just gonna add the chicken. Alright, so I'm back in the seat, you know. My plate is made. This air-fried chicken strips with pasta. My phone here. I totally forgot that one of the YouTubers that I enjoy watching, Coffee and Bible Time, if you guys are aware of it, heard of them, let me know also. But if you haven't, you guys should surely check them out. They have a new video out. I'm gonna watch them while I eat dinner. So I hope you guys enjoyed my video today, this vlog, and hanging out with me. You know, it was a nice filming it. So I'm just gonna go ahead over there, fold those clothes, get to editing, read a little bit, and just enjoy a relaxful time tonight. It's like a Thursday night, so I don't know, I don't have any plans. I'm gonna be home, so I'm gonna make use of my time. And that is all I have for today, guys. Thank you for watching as always. And don't be afraid to talk in the comments. I hope you guys have a blessed day and even greater, a blessed month and year. And yeah, guys, I'll see you all on my next video. Bye.